अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर वन ऑफ सेल ऑफ बायोलॉजी ऑफ पार्ट वन. दिस इज सेल स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन. इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अ जनरलाइज्ड सेल विद द हेल्प ऑफ डिफरेंट टेक्निक्स एंड प्रोसीजर्स. दोज प्रोसीजर्स दे आर नंबर वन, सेल फ्रैक्चनेशन. स्टूडेंट, सेल फ्रैक्चनेशन मीन्स टू डिवाइड और टू ब्रेक अप सेल्स. इट हैज टू स्टेप्स. वन इज कॉल्ड एज होमोजेनाइजेशन एंड अदर वन इज कॉल्ड एज सेंट्रीफ्यूगेशन. स्टूडेंट, सेल होमोजेनाइजेशन इज द formation of homogeneous mass of cells resulting into cell homogenate or cell suspension, while centrifugation is separation of substances on the basis of their size and densities by applying centrifugal force. Second technique which we use in cell biology, that is called as staining technique. It is of two types, single staining or simple staining, differential or double staining. So in single staining we use one type of stain, while in differential or double staining we use two types of stain to color different parts of cells. Next technique which we use in biology, that is micro dissection. Student, micro dissection is a technique which involves use of microscope. It is of two types, chromosomal microdissection and laser microdissection. Chromosomal microdissection that uses glass needles, while laser microdissection that uses laser light under a microscope to dissect different parts of a cell. Next technique, that is called as tissue culture. Tissue culture is growth of plant or animal cells or tissue on a chemically defined medium under sterile conditions. Next technique, that is called as paper chromatography. Student, chromatography is a procedure through which various substances in a mixture are separated from each other and identified. There are various techniques of chromatography, but paper chromatography is a simple and most widely used technique. Next is electrophoresis. Students, electrophoresis is use of electric field to separate molecules according to their size, shape, molecular weight and surface charge. Next is spectrophotometry. It is a technique used to detect and measure the absorption of different wavelengths of light by a particular chemical compound or photosynthetic pigment. Next is microscopy, to visualize cell or tissues. We use microscope and this procedure is called as what? Microscopy. In our labs, simple or light microscope that is used, which is also called as compound microscope, while in some advanced lab, electron microscope that is used. Next procedure that is called as what? Micrometry. Students, micrometry is measurement of microscopic objects. This can be done using specially designed scales, which are called as what? Micrometer. Now I will explain all these techniques one by one. First one is cell fractionation. Cell fractionation means to divide or break up. Cell fractionation is a procedure that allows different parts of a cell to be separated from each other by homogenization and centrifugation. Once the cells have been fractionated, organelles such as plasma membrane, nucleus and mitochondria, they can be studied separately. So as I told you, it has two steps. One is called as homogenization and other one is centrifugation. Homogenization is a process of making things uniform or similar, while centrifugation is the technique which involves the application of centrifugal force to separate particles from a solution according to their size, shape, density, viscosity of the medium, and rotor speed. Rotor speed means speed of that machine, which is called as centrifuge. This is centrifuge. You can see we place our sample in these test tubes, which are similar to that of the test tubes, and then we switch on the machine, and with the help of spinning, it can separate different components of cell or sample into different layers. Now this is after centrifugation. What happens before centrifugation? You can see this is a mixture, and then it is separated into two components. The one which is collected at the bottom of the tube, that is called as pellet, and the one which is collected at the top, that is called as what? Supernatant. Then we remove the supernatant and pellet can be collected, and supernatant, then it will be again centrifuged in the centrifuge machine to separate its components. Again and again, supernatant that will be used for centrifugation, and pellet that can be separated. Now, this is separation of blood cells after centrifugation. Let me show you a larger view of this. This is blood consisting of blood cells and plasma. You can see it consists of red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. And then after centrifugation, it has been divided into different layers. You can see at the bottom, being heavier in size or weight, red blood cells, they have been gathered or collected, which make up 41% of the blood. Middle layer is of white blood cells and platelets, which make up 4% of the blood, and plasma being lighter in weight, that will be collected at the top, and it makes about 55% of the blood. Next is types of centrifugation, which are given in your syllabus. There are two types of centrifugation: density gradient centrifugation and differential centrifugation. Student, we call it density gradient centrifugation as sucrose solution or cesium salt solution that is used as density gradient in this type, while differential centrifugation as again and again or repeatedly we can centrifuge the sample. That's why it is called as what? Differential centrifugation. So it refers to a separation method in which the substances are concentrated in the solutions of cesium salts or sucrose. The cesium salts or sucrose solution is called the density gradient. While differential certification is also called as differential pelleting, because in the form of pellet substances or components of the cells, they can be separated. The components of a cell can be separated by differential centrifugation. The differential centrifugation is based on the size of particles in the solution. Thus, the particles with different sizes sediment at different rates during the centrifugation. Means larger particles sediment faster than the smaller particles. The sedimentation rate can be increased by increasing the centrifugal force. Second difference is the separation occurs based on density of the particles, and here separation that occurs on the base of what? Size of particles. Means these are the two important things in density gradient centrifugation. Particles, they are separated on the basis of their density, while here they are separated on the basis of their size. Next is density gradient centrifugation is used to separate molecules or particles, while in differential centrifugation we use the separate cells, organelles or macromolecules. आप यहाँ पे देखें, हम मॉलिक्यूल्स और पार्टिकल्स को सेपरेट करते हैं, एंड हियर वी सेपरेट व्हाट? सेल्स, ऑर्गेनेल्स और मैक्रो मॉलिक्यूल्स. इन दिस केस अ होमोजेनाइज्ड सॉल्यूशन दैट इज यूज्ड एज सैंपल, व्हाइल हियर होमोजेनाइज्ड ऑर्गन दैट इज यूज्ड एज सैंपल. नाउ दिस इज अ फिगर, मीन्स यू कैन विजुलाइज द टू टाइप्स ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगेशन. So density gradient centrifugation, you can see this is the sample, and you can see red blood cells, neutrophils, white blood cells, plasma, etc. They have been separated on the basis of their density into different layers. While in differential centrifugation, first of all, larger particles, they will be collected at the bottom in the form of pellet. Then the particles which are being smaller in size than the first one, they will be collected. Then gradually the other particles, they will be collected which are smaller in size as compared to the previous one, and then the lightest particles, they will be collected at the bottom at the end. So this type of staining, where sample that is again and again centrifuged, that is called as what? Differential centrifugation. Okay, next is staining. So to color a material or object by applying a penetrative dye or chemical is called as staining. It has two types: single staining. It is a method of staining in which cells are stained by using a single stain. It is also called as what? Simple staining. Simple staining is also called as monochrome staining, because a single color that is used. Mono means one and chrome means color. Also called as positive staining. Example of single stains which are used, they are methylene blue, safranin and borax carmine. Next is double staining, a mixture of two dyes, each of which stains different portion of a tissue or cell. They are used in this type. In differential staining, hematoxylin is used to stain nucleus, while eosin is used to stain what? Cytoplasm. Student, you can see that eosin that is used to stain what? To stain cytoplasm, and let me underline it. While to stain hematoxylin that is used to stain what? That is used to stain nucleus. This is an important MCQ. Please keep this thing in your mind. Hematoxylin is used to stain nucleus, while eosin is used to stain what? To stain cytoplasm. Next is micro dissection. So what is microdissection? Microdissection refers to a variety of techniques where a microscope is used to assist in dissection. Two kinds of microdissection, they are chromosomal microdissection. In chromosomal microdissection, use a fine glass needle under a microscope to remove a portion from a complete chromosome. They are used. That's why it is called as what, chromosomal microdissection. And the second type is laser microdissection. It involves use of laser light through a microscope to dissect different cells. Thank you, student. This is all about today's lecture.